In this lecture, I will make my own grunge brush and use it to make a vector sticker. I will create the brush from an image. I go to File, Import. I open an image with waterfalls that I downloaded from Pixabay. To better see the potential of the water, I go to Filters, Grayscale. I lower the lightness. I will use the water on the left. I click on the rectangle tool and select a piece of the water. I hold Shift and also select the image. I right click and choose Set Clip. Now I will trace the water. To prevent tracing the whole image, I right click and choose Crop Image to Clip. I right click again and choose Trace Bitmap. To get the largest preview possible, I will drag the Trace Bitmap tab out of the tab group. And I will adjust the window to the top and bottom of my screen. For detection mode, I will choose Brightness Cutoff. With Threshold, I determine how much of the water gets white. I will set Threshold to 0.5. I will click on Invert to get a black brush. I click on Apply. I now have a black brush. I will call the path Brush. I will delete the image. I will remove some water from the bottom and from the side. To do this, I select the Node tool. I will also remove the nodes that are at the edges. The brush is finished, and I will rotate it to make it horizontal. Now I will drag a circle. I will duplicate the circle twice. I select the brush and copy it. I will hide two of the three circles. I go to Path Effects. From the menu I choose Pattern Along Path. Behind Pattern, I choose Single, Stretched. I click on the Paste Path icon. To make the brush a bit thinner, I use the Edit on Canvas tool. I drag the handle in. In my layers, I reveal the other circle and make it a bit smaller. To apply the effect, I go to Path, Object to Path. To make the circle and the edge interact, I shift click on the circle. Then I go to Path, Exclusion. Now the circle and the edge are a single path. I will place some text. I select the text tool and click on the sticker. I use Grand Hotel, which is a free Google font. I type best. To make the text italic, I can skew the text. And for the text below, I will use Varela Round, which also is a free Google font. To make the text more bold, I shift click on white. At the bottom left, I make the stroke smaller. Finally, I want to add a grunge stroke. I will make the last circle a bit smaller. And I give it a white stroke. I make the stroke thinner. To get a grunge stroke, I use two path effects. First, I will choose taper stroke. And then, I will add roughen. You can try out different looks by clicking on the recede icon.